Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Quest for Glory. I noticed that this music is slowing down. I don't know if that's normal. The cave is clammy and it smells like mildew and wet dog hair in here. The walls are covered with phosphorescent fungus. The fungus glows eerily in the cave's dim light. It's the hermit's staff. He needs a large staff to help him record his memoirs for posterity. Well, actually, this is not the staff, but okay. It's a relic from India, a snake charmer's basket. A place to keep grain for Ermit's ale. Henry always keeps a good supply of coal on hand. The fire is down to a set of dimly glowing coals. The hermit has all the amenities, including running water. A single candle sits upon a table. Yes, what you see is a table. Every ermit ought to have a few urns around, says I. It's a round chair. Okay. It's an ancient Egyptian pot from the tomb of Anan-Ha. Okay. That's the swinging, rocking cave entrance. You see the shaggiest little man, you think it's a man anyway, you've ever seen. I don't have much, but what I have, and tisn't for sale. Okay, ask him about his name again. I am Henry. Henry the Eighth, I is. Me father was an Henry, and his father was an Henry, and his father was an Henry, and his father was an Henry, etc. Etc. And everyone was an ermit. Excuse me, guys. Hermit. An ermit is one what lives alone, far away from them, what talks too much or asks too many questions. Ermits are shy, quiet types, what don't say much. You say much? My brother Ari hardly says a word in a year. My sister Hortense hasn't spoken since she was six. I never talks at all. Yes, we ermits knows how to keep a mouth shut. It's about the cave. Well, it is dark and damp and the waters roars, so there's not a moment's quiet. The ceiling drips and the walls are slimy and it's always cold. But oh well, says I, it's home. Family. My family lives pretty far apart from each other. We're all ermits, you know. Falls. This here's what's called the Flying Falls. I doon some flying falls around here myself. That porch gets slippery sometimes. Hee 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 hee. Ladder? I know some magic. Erasmus the wizard taught me some spells. He what put the spell on me ladder so's the brigands don't get up. Them what climbs the rocks gets a door opening in their nose. He's me friend, Ian Fenris. Powerful wizard he is. It's Erasmus. I hear his house is something to see up north. I don't make it out much, and he's pretty busy, so's I don't see him too often. But when we do all get together, you can be sure we'll have fun. He's loved to play his games, he do. Really. How about games? Erasmus' favorite game is the Mage's Maze. Have to be a magic user to play it, though. Erasmus is awful good at it. Oh, cool. Look forward to checking that out. What about Fenris? Fenris is Erasmus as familiar, or is that the other way around? Alright, brigands. Nasty sorts they is. I see them sneaking around the woods all the times. Other than the warlock, I has nothing to do with them. Warlock. He's not so bad. Got a good sense of humor. He is. I get the giggles just to think of him. And he laughs. He's come by at times to chat. Borrowed the mirror what I borrowed from Erasmus's dad. He did. Mirror. A magic mirror of reflection it was. If you use it when a nasty spell was cast at you, it what sent it back to the one that cast it. Do unto others, I says. Alright, that's it. I don't think there's anything else to do here. The remains of a Navajo ceremonial bridal pot. You see a cot. Alright. Leave. If you ever be needing a place to stay the night and you're in the area, I could be willing to put you up for the night for some rations and a couple of games of cribbage. Oh, okay. The music was getting away. Whoa. Okay. I have no idea why I would be acting like that, guys. Save here. Yeah, the whole thing's rather slowed down. Let's exit the screen. Oh, see, it's taking a long time just to do that. Okay, let's see if maybe the slowdown has improved. Yeah, we're back to normal. Something about this area just slowed everything down. So my graphics settings there. I turned my anti-aliasing off and... oh, my shading. Kidding. Joke. What kind of trouble we can get into. Now, I assume the farther I get away from the town, the worse the monsters will be. Whoa! The beautiful white stag is foraging for food. You seem to have startled the white stag. Alright, bye, white stag. Alright. Let's go where it was going. I should charge my weapon again. That's not it. Is now magically charged. Health is not too great. Maybe I should just take one of these. Because I'm rather far from home. I should just take one of these things. Which one is this? Oh, it's a vigor potion. Okay. So I just click it on myself. Oh, I know. The drink soothes as it goes down. Let's see what we got now. Alright, 22 out of 28. Don't even restore all the way. But... yeah, let's continue. See how far west we can go. There's the stag again. What if I sneak up to it and then touch it? Yeah. Okay. Not sure what we're supposed to do with that. Okay. Something interesting going on here. You follow the stag into this forest corner. You feel as though the eyes of the forest are watching you. You watch the stag fascinated with his grace and beauty. There is something special about this place. There are acorns here and there on the ground. Can I get them? You find an ordinary acorn on the ground. The acorn appears too ordinary. Drop it back on the ground. Are there any special ones? You can feel a gentle breeze wafting its way between the woods. The scent of fresh flowers and green glowing things fills you with a sense of peace. The large, gnarled oak seems to draw your attention. Whoa, are they like eyes? The rocks to the north look steep. There is a rock wall northeast of a large oak tree. In decay, this ancient tree lies as a bleak reminder that you really shouldn't have missed your last dentist appointment. The majestic white stag is an outstanding example of the beauty of the animal kingdom. Speak to tree. You better alter your strategy. The trees mostly just beach about their poplar neighbors or pine fir the fjords. Oak A. Oh, God. I'll touch the tree. Something about the old oak tree makes you reluctant to climb upon it. Well, it's catching my attention. There's something going on here. Most of the bushes around here seem to be bramble and are very thorny. Whoa! Awesome. The tree woman speaks, I am the Dryad, keeper of the woods. Are you one with the woods? Yes. Then you shall aid me, and I shall aid you in your quest. Bring me a seed from the spore-spitting spirea of the north, that I may plant it elsewhere in order to preserve these rare and magical plants.
Okay, of the north.
Then you'll become a true friend of the forest. Well, you didn't tell me how I would help you. Yeah. You didn't tell me, I mean, how you would help me. Oh, I can't advance past these things. Very interesting. Yeah, Dryad. Let's go this way. North. Is this that graveyard? What'd it say? It's a ring formed of large and rather unusual-looking mushrooms. There's a face on this. This used to be a member of a famous rock group, but it decided to split the scene. You don't need to do that. Look at that. Trees seem more dense and lush than the rest of the woods. Trees here look thicker and healthier than other parts of the forest. Is this Arana's piece? Huh. You don't need to do that. Let's stand in the middle of the mushrooms. Okay. You pick a handful of the smaller mushrooms and carefully put them away in your backpack. Three mushrooms. Too bad this doesn't really describe anything when you look at something in your inventory. That is interesting, though. Let's see if I can live. Getting easier. That one was really easy. 5 silver coins. What is this thing? Oh, that's part of it. Just saving often. Oliver Stone. There are Mount Everest, circa 8 zillion BC. It gets bigger. These are just random things. Gibraltar, they ain't. Corning never made these hunks of silicon. Rock Hudson. Scared me. Sorry, guys. What the hell is this? The meadow is covered with a light carpet of grass broken up by the meep holes. The mountains are very steep here. Large, heavy-looking rocks cover the many holes. The meeps must be stronger than they look to lift these rocks so easily. There seems to be an abundant supply of blue and purple meeps. If only they'd stay still for a moment, you'd be able to count them. Why would I want to count them? Whoa, what is that? A scroll just flew out of nowhere. You pick up the spell scroll. As the magic runes fade, you know now how to cast the detect magic spell. Sweet. Sorry, guys. Hit the wire here. Tech magic. There's no magic in this area. That was the one I was going to pick this one up and a scroll flew out. Let's see if one of them will pop up, like this one. Interesting. Can I talk to these things? You hear squeaky muttering from beneath the ground. It seems the meeps are having quite a discussion about you. Hearing a rumble from the meep hole, you quickly slip out of the way. Uh-oh. A rumble? Hiya, hiya. Pleased to meet ya. Look at this thing. You realize you have never seen more than one green meep at a time. Perhaps there is only one. I asked them about themselves. We are happy meeps living in our happy holes. Don't worry. Be happy. Rocks? We use rocks for doors. They keep us dry and warm in our holes. Holes? We, like, live in tunnels under the ground, you know? Fur. Hey, like, fur is good stuff. Keeps us warm. Mine's the best. It's, like, green, you know? Oh, you want some green fur? I think I have some somewhere. Can you give me green fur? Okay. Before I take that, I'll ask you about the brigands. Gee, boss, I really don't know much about that at all. Hey, sorry. Heh. Oh, there he goes. Alright, let's get this then. Pick up the green fur. So I got green meep fur. One piece of green fur. Let's see if we can... I got another one coming out or something. That's the same one. Hi, hi, nice to see you again. Alright. I can't talk to him about anything else. Let me see something. Hey, what if I go like this? Poke. Nope. Ah. Okay. Alright, guys. Thanks for watching. Interesting. Meep fur. I guess I can use it for something. Or give it to somebody in exchange for something. Dunno. Well, thanks for watching as always, and this is Nord Pudding.